Vote for the redhead you can trust. That's the slogan Pauline Hanson used to launch her ninth political campaign and One Nation's first tilt at federal politics since the late 1990s. She's hoping to grab a Senate seat in September's election because she says voters can't count on the existing parties. Zoe Ford has the story.
Today I'm very proud to announce that I will be standing in New South Wales for the Senate for One Nation.
Pauline Hanson is back.
Well, it tells you I don't give up easily, doesn't it?
This will be her ninth political campaign. She's lost the last seven. This time, though, she says she can really make a difference.
As I speak to many Australians, they're in a dilemma of who to vote for. They don't particularly want the Labor Party, and they don't particularly want Tony Abbott either.
Pauline Hanson hopes to keep them all honest.
I love my country and I believe that we do need to stand up and fight. Why throw the towel in? Why let them beat me? Yes, I've been to prison, I've been trodden on, but I keep getting up.
That prison reference goes back a decade now, when charges of electoral fraud were dismissed, but only after Ms Hanson spent 3 months in jail.
Just give me a minute just to catch my breath.
Since the birth of One Nation, the Queensland fish and chip shop owner turned politician has been controversial.
We are in danger of being swamped by Asians. They have their own culture and religion, form ghettos and do not assimilate.
16 years later, little has changed. She's running policies against asylum seekers, welfare rorting and foreign aid.
We've got to start getting border protection back. Looking after our own, clean up our own backyard first before we worry about everyone else around the world.
Groups like the Shooters Party and Pauline Hanson will hold the country to ransom with their extreme views.
We're going to see the same old toxic mix of xenophobia and anti-immigrant politics that she's so well known for.
Some, though, welcome her return.
I think she's a good chance. She's got my vote.
It's good to have another choice. No one's really very confident in what we've got at the moment.
Election watchers say there is an outside chance One Nation could win a Senate seat by doing preference deals with right-wing parties. Pauline Hanson hopes it won't have to come to that.
So in the Senate, a vote for One Nation is a vote for Pauline Hanson. And I will say, the redhead you can trust.
There we go, Ms. Zoe Ford with that report.